It's engineer time. So where do we buy it? Here? Monkeys? Oh, do we have it unlocked? Yes, it is. Engineer monkey. Here are all the engineer upgrades. So we're gonna try to unlock this ASAP, because that's obviously the biggest thing in this update. New Azili skin. Let's just do everything in this new update. Azili has a skin called Smudge Cat. What the hell? Not sure I'm a fan of this, but sure. I'll take it. So we're gonna try to unlock it on the new maps. Yeah, advanced. There's one called Spillway. There's one called Workshop, so must be another toughie like Muddy Puddles, ouch, Dark Castle, but we'll do this one first. Take it easy. Hard mode. Let's get started, shall we? Engineer, can he place on this map? Oh boy. I sure hope the new tower can work on this map, because you can't place towers in here. Can I get a pontoon? F it. No! No pontoon. Wait, wait, wait. Yes. Pontoon. I don't care. We're gonna use engineer no matter what. Oh, he can't shoot over the wall. Really, Ninja Kiwi? A new map and I can't use a new tower on it. My disappointment has never been higher. We're gonna get 4 engineers. You know what? Yeah, cash drop. Cash drop time. Ninja Kiwi has forced us to do this. 4 engineers, boys, right here. So we don't want to drop any other towers if we want to maximize, you know, the XP with the engineer. So I'm gonna just get Azili. Heroes don't affect it. And let's wait for XP. Sentry gun, obviously. You guys know what this is if you played PT5 before. Battles. Deploy sentries all around the radius. Let's see how many they spawn with this one upgrade. We'll get oversized nails, increased popping power, and frozen balloons. So let's try to wait for faster engineering. So it looks like the first two upgrades with the engineer is about the same as BTD Battles, BT5. More sentries. How many can they spawn? 4? Let's see. It looks to be about on par with Battles, TD5. So they didn't change much. What are the red things on this map? Oh! What is this? 2K? I can't afford that. We don't yet know what happens when the balloons get in here, do we? Well, they loop. But where do they exit? Do they ever go in the middle? Let's see. Oh no, no, they zap. That's cool. Anyways, let's get pin. What is this? Pins balloons in place for a short time when struck. So it's a stun. Let's take a look. Unlock. Purchase. Is it only the main attack? That zap is Azili. Oh right, she shoots over the wall. My bad. My bad. I thought it was like a unique map thing. Sorry, zero IQ. Anyways, we got enough for sprockets now. We're just gonna go straight to top and bottom path. We'll deal with the middle path later. Increases sentry gun and engineer attack speed. We'll take it. So you see, engineer is pretty cheap. Tier 3 upgrade is less than 1k. Damn. Definitely an early game tower, at least for this guy. Alright. 2k. Let's see what happens. Slow down. Got an engineer. Opens the floodgates. I guess it just allows you to see through it. Let me just see. Yeah. Okay. I see. And you can remove all 4 of them. Pretty expensive, I don't know about that. Alright, we're leaking balloons now, so it looks like they loop once? They never go in the middle, but I assume they exit from the same place they started at. Well, that's just an assumption. So, because I'm lazy, let me do this. Cast drop, remove. I want an NG that gets every balloon, right here. Sentries. I'm gonna start upgrading middle path. So, larger surface area, makes sense. We know. Deconstruction. Well, not useful for now, but not bad. Cleansing foam. Let's get that too. Alright. Can I place on the radiation can in the middle? Let's see. Oh. I did not know that. I really shouldn't have used the pontoon if I knew that. God damn. We found a better NG spot. Lots is too big. Can only tiny towers fit? Sniper? NG? Yeah, NG's too big. Wow. Okay, never mind. We didn't mess up. But I can't believe this hitbox looks so tiny. How can he not fit there? So, wow, this is really cheap. 215? My god. This is rivaling, like, Dark Monkey levels of, you know, early game. Every upgrade so far has been, like, less than 1k. So he's hella early game. Anyways, Cleansing Foam will help for, 28 here. Let's get that soon. Can I put a kiddie pool on the radiation tank? Let me see. No, it's too big. Anyways, Cleansing Foam now? Good stuff. Overclock. So we've seen this before. Target ability becomes super powerful for 60 seconds. Seems about right. So how's our engineer game only doing on this map? Not that great, honestly, but I have no idea what the strategy is right now. But I suppose we should go for a bottom path now, yeah. Let's try to place two over here. Can I sell sentry? Oh wow, there we go, there we go. So, oversized nails. Pin. I haven't seen what pin does. Okay, I see, I see. Looks like pin pins the balloons in place, you see there? Only on the main attack. Not bad. Not bad for actually $200. Pretty cheap. And then let's get the double guns now. Another cheap upgrade. Only 500. Sentry doesn't block placing towers, really. Let me just see. Oh, you're right. That's good. That's good. Great change in Takui. I know that was really annoying when I was playing battles, BTT5. Trying to place towers. Building sentries. Couldn't place any towers because, obviously, sentries took up everything. Anyways, we can afford a balloon trap now. Okay, it's been moved to bond path. 11k XP, let's get it. So, balloon trap, let's get it. Ooh, it's spicy. We got a spicy 3D balloon trap coming in. Come in hot. Now, let's see if it's still OP compared to the last game. And let's see if these NGs can beat 40, because I don't know. Where does the mob come from? I assume top left. So, right now, we are screwed if we try to beat this. Definitely with early game NGs, it's not going to do damn near enough. Oh, wait, wait. Does blue trap do damage to mobs? Because I swear that just got one shot. I also couldn't tell how much money we got there, but that if that affects mobs, that's good. Anyways, we got tier 4 now, top path. What is this? Sentry Expert. Sentries deploy with different damage types based on your need. What does that mean? Can we choose? Oh boy, if we can choose. Let's see. Let's wait for a sentry to spawn. Red? Or is it random? What does a red one do? I don't know. Look at the name of the sentry. Okay. Crushing sentry. Energy sentry. I don't know what it does though. There's no description. I see energy fires a laser. Is that all it does? What does crushing do? Let's see. Oh, it's a mini juggernaut ball. Wow. Shooting mini juggernauts. And what's next? Crushing deals damage to ceramics, and energy has a lot of pump power. I see. And then the black one allows it to shoot black balloons and zebras. Okay. Boom sentry. What a name. What a name. And then cold sentry. I assume white balloons. Or something. Frozen balloons. Also, we got 1k from the balloon trap. Holy crap, that's a lot. And then moabs. It seems like that one doesn't affect it. Maybe it just so happened to pop at that time. Yeah, I don't know if it does damage. I don't think it hit that time. Anyways, we're dead. Okay. This is not a map for engineers. I think you guys know that by now. Hold on. Do we have it yet? Oh, we have it. We have it. Sentry. Let's get it. We don't have 34k though. That's okay. I will cheat a little bit afterwards. In a bit. Oh. Are we dead there? 12 lives. Jesus Christ. So, hold on. Let me reset here. NGs are gonna have a problem with this round. Let's start selling for this guy, alright? I need 9k. 9k. Sell. 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 Do we do it? I think so. I believe 5-2-2 is better, I don't know exactly, but here we go. I sure hope this guy has enough range, because this is the Paragon Sentry that we're looking at. How much damage? It's a plasma monkey, basically. Alright. Do we beat- Whoa, we just beat 63. Thanks, Balloon Traps. I guess we're not screwed. Balloon Trap coming in clutch. And these sentry spots are goddamn awful. But not bad, Balloon Traps actually do the job pretty nicely. We just might win this way, guys. Let's see. Last wave. Come on. Uh-oh. 11? Ah, so close, so close. Let me give some range on these sentries, can we? Like this. Attack speed and range. Might be enough. Looks like they're all the same, so it's not like tier 4 where like each sentry is different. There we go, plasma coming in clutch to beat 63 here. I'll take it. Anyways, can I buy overclock yet? Let me just see. Yes, we can. 14k. These are a little bit heavy. Holy crap, that cost. We're not gonna get that this game. No way, Jose. Let me just first start with overclock then. The good old usual, we all know what it does. Is there a percentage that we can see? No. Just super powered. So we're obviously gonna do this. We're gonna buff this sentry here, tier 5. Actually, hold on, hold on. Do we want to do that? Because if we buff it, I don't know if the buffs stack onto the sentry. Unless we have to, like, actually buff the sentry itself to make it good. Alright, we got overclock. Let's see. So, which tower do we buff? Do we do it? I'm gonna try. Because we have no info yet, we're gonna be the first to see what info is there. What does it do if we buff this guy? Does it affect the sentries? I don't think so. But we could be wrong. Yeah, it doesn't. Because you can see here, there's an icon. This icon means it's being buffed by Jungle Drums, the Range of the Village, and the Overclock. Sentries, no, so that was a waste. It was a waste of money doing that on the sentry. So we'll wait again. I think he makes more sentries. I don't know, it's kind of hard to tell. You could be right. Does it say attack speed or just, it says super powered, so maybe. Anyways, let me just buff a sentry right here. Which one? This one? Let's take a look. The pop count. If there's boons on screen, we picked the wrong time, boys, to use the ability. Oh wait, did it disappear? Oh yeah, it's gone. Yeah, note to self. Don't buff the sentries with the overclock. They might disappear like right now, which it has. Rip to that. Alright, we got it, guys. 40k XP. XXXL trap. Description: huge boon traps that trap even the largest of bloons. Oh, even a bad? No, you're kidding, right? 64.8. Do we have the money for that? Well, we can make money. I mean, guys, we've seen enough of this guy, right? We've seen enough of the Paragon Sentry. I think we can sell it now, but I'm gonna wait. Yeah, let me just see if the sentries can beat 76 too. Come on, sentries. And bloon traps, come on. Shoot your lasers better. Faster. Good, good, good. Barely got that in time. So, I'm gonna do it. If nobody objects. And damn right nobody should object, because I want to see it for the first time. So let me just sell a few more towers. This guy. Oh! Overclock. That's fine, it's fine. I don't care. Get rid of it. I want the XXXL. Where is it? Please spawn. There we go. Nice. So let's see what it does. I'm also going to overclock it or outbuff it. I'm not sure if outbuff affects the amount of balloons that the trap can affect, but I hope so. So we're just going to drop that real quick. Let's see. It eats mobs, obviously. It should eat up BFBs, if I'm not mistaken. Let's see it. Yep, BFB. Insta-gone. Insta-gibbed. Still active, by the way. Oh, it's gone now. $2,700. Not bad. And just drops in time to save us. Nice. I gotta say, this guy's making a mad stack, so I can't complain. Ceram seemed to be immune to pin. Oh, really? Before the Cerams come out again, I wanna see if that's true or not. It's a pretty good upgrade though, yeah, not gonna lie. For $200, you can't go wrong with it. And yes, it does not pin Cerams, I see. This is really all you could wish for in an update. Expert map for the hardcore players. Engineer for literally everyone who wants it. Which, apparently, is literally everyone in the community. What else could you go wrong with in this update? Azalea skin. Actually, you could go wrong. There are some pretty bad nerfs. Like, really bad. I didn't talk about it yet in this game. I'll get to it eventually, though. But just in the gist of it, like, first strike, big nerf. Knockback super, big nerf. There might be a few more that I didn't mention, but yeah. A lot more nerfs this patch than buffs, I think. Does XXX trap eat the ZMG? Somebody said yes, but I'm just gonna pretend like I didn't see it. So I'm gonna act surprised. Over nerf or justified? I think some of it was over nerfed, like knockback supers. And it does, okay. It does eat up a ZMG, not bad. And it's still active too. Oh, never mind. She gone now, so I'm actually going to quit this game because XP is gone. We got one more upgrade to unlock, not bad. We're actually almost there too. So because Ultra Boost is too expensive to afford in a real game, we're gonna do the easy way out. Tier 5, let me edit. 129,600, man, that's so much. That's like big plane levels of money, isn't it? Let's just see. Yeah, well actually, it's more. It's more than that, okay. So, description, overclock monkeys gain a small but permanent boost each time. Oh, it stacks. How many times? Well, let's find out. What's a good tower to test with? Grandmaster? Yeah, sure, why not? Alright, so one Grandmaster versus two ZMGs. Let's just see. Alright, so we got overclock active on two ZMGs. Overclock still active. And how we doing? I think it's off now. Yeah, it's off. When you see the X1, it means the ability has worn off, but it's got a permanent buff. So 10% attack speed, I think someone's mentioned. Alright. 10% and it stacks 9 times. Well, 9 more times, so make it 10. You can double the attack speed permanently of a tower if you use it 10 times, but that's a lot of times to use it. And yeah. You gotta wait a long time to buy this, so it's really just a late game tower, I think. This Ultra Boost. So we're gonna give it 10 buffs. Let's do it. Alright, we got 10. Nice. Now, I'm gonna put 10 and this guy, overclock. We got quadruple attack speed, let's see. 2 ZMGs now. How fast? Well, a lot of light coming in, that's for sure. And it's not active anymore, but the perma attack speed is pretty nice. Still shooting double. And we should have this, right? Come on, ninja. Oh, he still leaks a little bit.